Grouping objects can be very efficient, because it allows you to adjust their properties all at the same time. Let's group these four squares. I drag over the squares to select them all. Then I right-click, and select, Group. I can now move the squares, as if they were a single object. I hold down the Control key, and drag a corner to scale the group. I can also rotate the group. In the outline window, the group is shown. When I hold my mouse above an element of the group, I see a preview of it. Let's say, I want to adjust the blue square. I could ungroup the group, then move the square, and group again. But I don't have to do this. In the outline window, I can click on an element to select it. I can now move the square, inside the group. I can scale the square, and in the shape panel, I can even change the square to a circle. If I move an element, outside of the boundaries of the group, it will be cut off. If you don't want the circle to be cut off, deselect, Group Clips Content. Now let's make a group with text. I draw a circle, and make it yellow. I draw a text frame. I give in the text, and center it. I make the text larger, and increase the line spacing. To align the text and the circle, I select the circle and the text. I open the Align panel, by going to Windows, Align and Distribute. I click on the center vertical icon. With my arrow down key, I lower the frame a bit. Now I want to group the text and the circle. I drag over them, right click, and select, Group. You can also press, Ctrl G. I can now scale the icon, as it is one object. Let's say, I want to adjust the text. I can open the group, and select the text. I click on the text frame. Then I double click on the text frame, and adjust the text. Lastly, let's make an icon that has a group, within a group. I click on the polygon tool, and keep my mouse pressed down. Then I click on properties. I want 20 corners, and want the corners sticking out 20%. I click on OK. I hold down the control key, and drag a shape. I want no stroke, and a magenta fill. I drag a text frame. I type, 50%. For my font, I choose assistant. And I choose bold. I make the text larger. And I make the text white. I center the text. I duplicate the text frame, by pressing Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V. I type, off sale. I make the text smaller. I want the text to be the same width, as the text above. With my up and down arrows, I position the text. I shift click on the text frame above, and in the align panel, I click on the center vertical icon. I right click, and choose, group. Now I shift click on the icon, so I have both the text and the icon selected. In the align panel, I click on the center vertical icon. I right click again, and choose, group. In the outline window, I can see I have a group. In this group is the text group, together with the icon. Let's say, I want the text group to be larger. I click on the text group icon. To scale the text group, I hold down the control key, together with the shift key. Now I can scale the text from the center. In the next lecture, we will make the summer sale icon, which has a color gradient.